to everyone in Russia for having us. It's taken a long time to obviously get to to get to 100, and I wasn't even sure whether or not you would come. Next one, right?
Nice
Lando,
touch.
Lando did such an amazing job. He had incredible pace. He's doing such a great job for McLaren. And
if you have not noticed, Lewis Hamilton had just won the Russian Grand Prix for his 100th win in Formula 1, becoming the first driver to do so. This, however, did not come with good timing. Lando Norris, who was in pole position to win the race, refused to change tires in spite of the incoming rain. Therefore, when the rain got heavier, his lead slipped as quickly as Nikita Mazepin spinning in Bahrain. However, I would like to do something different and cast your minds back to 2007. The previous year, you were racing in GP2, with a GP2 car, a GP2 engine, and a GP2 field. And guess what? You obviously won GP2. The next year, you were promoted to McLaren, to race alongside a two-time defending world champion. However, you proved the doubters wrong. You are not just having a good season, you are having one of the best rookie seasons ever witnessed in Formula 1 history. You won the Hungarian Grand Prix despite controversy happening the previous day during qualifying. 2 months later, you were racing in China, and here we are about to witness the defining moment of the season, to put it very kindly.
And as you saw, Jenson Button is out there on tyres, doing a good job.
Becky Chen into the pits anyway, comes Lewis Hamilton, he goes straight on, into the gravel track, can he keep the wheel spinning? Can he get some momentum going?
No,
he can't, it's all going to get away from him. He's not allowed to get a push. He's in the pit lane, need to get the rule book out here and see if he can get a push in the pit lane. He's trying to keep the engine running. It's all getting away from him here, Raikkonen. The marshals don't seem to want to help him. And, the chance to leave here as the world champion seems to have gone away. He was struggling like mad on those tyres out there. And they didn't bring him in, the McLaren team, any earlier. And this is the result of it. It looks like it's all going to be over. The rear wheels are still turning. You can see that right rear is down to the canvas. And
I don't understand why it doesn't look that slippery. The mechanics can't go down and help him. They're not allowed past the white line at the beginning of the pit lane. Ted.
Utter frustration and despair down here at McLaren. The guys at the back of the garage have got their hands on their heads. The tyres that they brought out were in Alonso's covers, but they got Lewis's tyres as well, so they were ready. They'd seen it. They got on the radio. It worked, but in the Nürburgring, tell the marshals to actually push you, but it seems that the message just got lost in translation and couldn't let the Chinese marshals, but now they've got Alonso's tyres in the pit lane too. Distraught at McLaren here.
2 weeks later, you and your team had the chance to redeem yourselves in Brazil. And then this happened.
Hamilton displaces the BMW of Heidfeld for sixth. The McLaren garage remains positive. It's looking good at the moment. But no, he's slowing. Impossible! That's 4 places lost already. How can this be happening? It's the worst possible time for a gearbox issue. Somehow the system resets itself and he manages to get going again. But he's way back. The Ferraris have really got the measure of McLaren when it matters most. And despite their lead, Alonso will win the championship unless Kimi can find a way past Massa.
Unfortunately, your team did not win the Constructors' Championship thanks to disqualification as a result of the Spygate scandal. And also, you would lose the championship to Kimi Raikkonen by just 1 point. Unbelievable. And this right here is why Lando Norris hugged Lewis Hamilton. It is not just because of congratulations, but it's also because Lewis has an experience of what it's like to lose. Agonizingly. That is all for me today. Thank you for watching this video, and I will see you next time.